Welcome to the eAcademy. In this episode, we'll focus on the PERFECTA 64M control panel, or more specifically, on its interaction with wireless devices. Let me remind you that the PERFECTA 64M control panel does not have a built-in module supporting radio communication. So, if you want to use wireless devices, it is necessary to connect one of the three modules. And so, it can be one of the ABAX2 system controllers, namely ACU220 or ACU280. If you opt for microsystem devices, the PERFECTA RF module should be connected to the control panel. The last, third available option is the INT RXS module, supporting SATEL remote key fobs operating on the 433 MHz frequency band. Here it is only worth mentioning that the ABAX2 system uses the 868 MHz radio frequency, while the microsystem operates on the 433 MHz band. And here's an important point. Only one of the mentioned modules can work with the PERFECTA 64M control panel at a time. Let's go on. The system we are going to use was already prepared in the previous episode. The connected devices are already identified. I would like to remind you that we talked more about the programming of the PERFECTA family control panels using the keypad and the PERFECTA soft software in episodes 36 and 37. So let's move on to the configuration program. The project with the settings of our system has already been opened in the PERFECTA soft. Let's establish a connection using the USB RS converter. Read out the data from the control panel and go to the Hardware tab. You can see that only the integrated GSM phone module and the two keypads connected in the previous episode are marked in green in the list. And at the end of the list is the key fobs receiver module. Click on it. Text boxes are empty, which means there is no information about the device. This is because, at the moment, no module is connected, or at least none has been identified. So why are the key fob receiver module settings displayed in the program? This is because the PERFECTA 64M panel, by default, behaves in a similar way to the basic PERFECTA panel models, namely those without the WRL designation. In other words, the control panels that are not equipped by default with the micro module supporting wireless devices. It is to these control panels that the INT RXS, or the key fob receiver module, can be connected. Now let's have another look at the Users tab. As you can see, at the moment there is no menu here for the key fob allocation. Let's see what happens when you connect the INT RXS module. Okay, in the meantime, the device has been connected to the control panel bus. Let's see what changes will appear in the program. Perform the identification. You can do this using the keypad or the PERFECTA soft program itself. So go to the Hardware Mainboard tab and click on Detect Connected Modules. Three modules had been found. Two of these are previously connected keypads. Approve the data readout and check what the third module is. The third one should be the key fobs module. And this is indeed the case. This position has turned green. As we can see, the INT RXS has appeared in the type field, so we can also check the module's firmware version. By the way, you should note that the INT RXS module, when operating together with the PERFECTA 64M control panel, should have its address set to 7. Let's take a look at the Users tab again. An additional table has appeared here, in which you can add and configure users' key fobs interacting with the INT RXS module. At present, several key fobs models are available. The way how to add key fobs to PERFECTA control panels and configure them was discussed at the end of episode 38. And although we talked about WRL marked control panels at the time, basically, the process is the same here too. Basically, that is all for the INT RXS key fob receiver module. Now I'm going to briefly discuss the interaction between the PERFECTA 64M control panel and the micro wireless system. Why won't I discuss it in more detail? Because adding the programming radio devices follows the same procedure as for the PERFECTA WRL control panels. The main difference compared to them is that the PERFECTA 64M control panel does not have a built-in radio module, so it is necessary to use the PERFECTA RF module mentioned at the beginning of this episode. The case is that this module is non-typical because you do not connect it directly to the bus terminals, as is the case with other expansion modules that interact with the control panel. This particular device must be plugged in a special connector on the control panel electronics board. Let's check it out. The main power supply and battery have been disconnected from the control panel. In the meantime, the INT-RXS, which is no longer needed, has been disconnected too. Do not use much force when installing PERFECTA RF module. A slight inattention, and you can easily bend the pins. So press down the module carefully. It's ready now. If you want the control panel to start up in the service mode, short-circuit the reset pins. Now the power can be restored. When the LEDs next to the pin stop flashing, remove the jumper. Let's get back to the program. After the reset, you have to re-establish the connection with the control panel. To detect the recently connected module, it is necessary to repeat the identification process. Okay, three devices have been found. Read data from the panel to see what has changed compared to the previous configuration. In addition to the keypads, a radio 433 MHz position appeared in the list instead of the key fob receiver module. When you click on this box, only a brief message is displayed. This is because functions for adding radio devices and fields for changing their parameters are available elsewhere. All this works similarly to the previously mentioned control panels with the WRL designation. Again, I remind you that their configuration was discussed in detail in episode 38. The difference will be that you can simply add more detectors or key fobs to the PERFECTA 64M control panel than it was possible with the other models. We will now only take a quick look at the relevant tabs and select the options we are interested in. In the Hardware tab, find all the keypads. Select one of the items, the one in grey colour. It is about a location, or rather an address, to which no device has yet been assigned. A plus button can be seen at the bottom of the window. After clicking on it, you can add a wireless keypad to the system. The model I mean here is the PERF LCD WRL. It looks the same as the PERF LCD wired keypad. However, the difference is that it communicates using radio and needs two CR123A type batteries to operate. And here's a note. The PERF LCD WRL keypads with electronics version 2.2 or later can be supplied with 5 volts DC voltage. The same is true for the PERF LCD A2 keypads designed for operation in the ABAX2 system. These models are equipped with terminals for connecting the APS-055 external power supply. This small device can be installed, for example, in a flush-mounted box located behind the keypad or in its immediate vicinity. In such a case, the batteries will only provide backup power supply. Okay, now let's go to the Zones tab. In the options of the selected zones, on the right side of the window, you can see the function for adding a wireless detector. An important note, in the case of microsystem detectors, they can be assigned to each of the available zones, that is, from number 1 to 64. So let's go on to the Outputs tab. If the PERFECTA RF module is connected to the control panel, up to 4 MSP300 wireless alarm devices can be registered. You can only add them on positions numbered 13 to 16. For distinction, they are marked with an antenna symbol in the program. The last tab we will look at is the one labeled Users. As was the case with the INT-RXS module, the Key Fobs menu is now available. Key fobs can be added and configured using the same method as mentioned earlier. The difference is that the PERFECTA RF module only supports MPT-350 key fobs. And finally, we will turn to the third option, which was previously not available at all for the PERFECTA control panel's family. What I mean is the ABAX2 wireless system, because this is what the PERFECTA 64M model interacts with as the only control panel in the family. Let's now turn the power off and disconnect the PERFECTA RF module gently. Next, connect one of the ABAX2 controllers to the bus. In our case, it is the ACU220 model. Now switch on the power while remembering to start the service mode. detection of the connected devices. Again, you can see that 3 modules have been found. Let's read the data. Okay, the device marked as wireless module has appeared in the list. But that's where we end today's episode. As the interaction between the ABAX2 system and the control panel of the PERFECTA family is a kind of innovation, adding devices and configuration will be discussed in more detail next time. Thank you, and feel invited to another meeting in eAcademy. See you then.